Hey guys, it's Mike and Maddie. Today we're talking about spaced repetition. It's one of the best scientifically proven study strategies that'll help you retain information long-term so that you can ace your exams. So we're gonna talk about what it is, and then by the end of the video, show you how to actually use it in your study sessions.
And if you're new to the channel, definitely hit the subscribe button. We'll be posting weekly productivity and study tips. Spaced repetition is best explained by a graph. So let's call the x-axis here time, and the y-axis how well you know something. When you finish learning or going to class, your mastery of the information is gonna be really high because it's fresh on your mind and you know it very well. Now, naturally, over time, you're gonna start to forget that information, no matter how well you learned it the first time. Science finds that the rate at which most people forget is exponential, which means on the graph, it's gonna look something like this. This is, of course, if we don't ever review that information again. So when we do review the material again, we see another jump back to the top, and this cycle repeats. But the more you review a topic, we start to see that the distance it drops increases slowly with time. And this is due to the fact that our brains are beginning to consolidate that information into long-term memory. So practice makes perfect, right? Just keep reviewing your notes over and over until you master everything. Well, sure, but that's not really the smartest way to learn, especially if you have 20 credits and a ton of homework to do every night. Spaced repetition plays on the fact that you only need to review material just as you're about to forget it. And that way, you're not wasting your time reviewing things that you already know. If you study the same topic 5 days in a row, and then take a test 25 days later, you're probably not gonna do very well. This is because you haven't allowed your brain to consolidate that information into long-term memory. However, if you space out when you review over 30 days, you'll probably do a lot better, even though you spent the same total time reviewing that topic. So, to put it simply, for something that you know very well, review it less often. Space it out. And for something that you don't know well, review it more often. Practice doesn't make perfect. Perfect practice makes perfect. This is the perfect way to study, the smart way to study, so that you can master all the information in all of your classes in the most efficient way possible. You don't need to review everything every single day, just the things that you're about to forget.
So now that you understand the concept behind it, I want to provide you with an example of how you can use spaced repetition in your studies. So in order for you to get the most out of the strategy, you want to make sure that you understand your material thoroughly the first time you learn it. A good way to do this is by teaching back or using the protege effect or the Feynman technique. If you aren't sure what any of these strategies are, then definitely check out this video right here after you finish with this one. So you'll start using spaced repetition after your first pass through the material. So one day later, you want to revisit your notes again to review the material. And I know that a lot of students like to take a little bit of time immediately after their lectures to review their notes again to really solidify the information. And I think that's a really good idea. But remember, you want to at least review it one day after your first pass, and then 3 days later, you want to review it again. And then a week later, and then a month later, keep spacing out the amount of time that you're going to review your notes. But if at any point during this process, you feel uncertain about the information, then you may have forgotten it. So you want to restart the cycle at one day again. But you can see that if you keep this consistency up, all the information that you know very well will be spaced far out and you'll be visiting it less often. And all the information that you don't know well, you'll be seeing much more often. So as you can imagine, if you're in school and keeping up with all your reading and assignments, it can get really messy keeping track of all the days and what topics you need to be reviewing. And this is why I recommend you use apps like Anki or Remnote. They're both flashcard apps that have spaced repetition software built into their interface, so it takes out all the guesswork and all the labor of spacing out your own studies. And being flashcard apps, they also use active recall, which is another scientifically superior study strategy. And if you don't know what active recall is, we covered it in a different video, which you can find right here. And additionally, Remnote can be used as a note-taking app, which just makes everything so much easier by combining all your study needs into one tool. So definitely check out these programs, Anki and Remnote. We'll leave some helpful links in the description below for you. So that is spaced repetition in a nutshell and how you can be using it in your study sessions. If you have any questions, leave it in the comments below. And don't forget to check out our website, mikeandmaddie.com. We have a whole library of free study guides and eBooks that you can download today. We'll leave a link in the description below and at the end of the video. So definitely check that out. And thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that video. Give it a thumbs up because it really helps us out. And if you want to see more, click on the red subscribe button down here or the circle up here.
Check out our website or check out our Instagram, links in the description below. And check out these videos over here. We think you might enjoy them.
And we'll see you next time.